Blue Origin has been diligently preparing for the momentous occasion when its New Glenn rocket will launch from Florida, and now the company is on the verge of making history. It's a long-awaited development. However, in keeping with its established pattern, Blue Origin has consistently disappointed, as New Glenn's launch date has been subject to multiple delays. Originally scheduled for late 2024, the schedule was later adjusted to January 6th, and now it has been pushed back again to January 10th to coincide with SpaceX Starship launch. What exactly is the situation regarding Blue Origin's New Glenn? Could the choice to launch alongside Starship be a strategic maneuver aimed at getting ahead of SpaceX's flagship project? Join us as we explore these questions on today's episode of NR Studio. It looked like New Glenn was all set for its maiden launch on January 6th, delivering a festive New Year's gift. However, to our dismay, Blue Origin has once again delayed its launch, initially rescheduled for January 8th and then to January 10th. The launch originally planned for October to advance NASA's Escapade mission has been postponed due to the ongoing New Glenn delays. It is worth noting that delays in the maiden launch of a new rocket are relatively common in the aerospace sector. However, for Blue Origin, a major entity and a reliable collaborator with the U.S. government, the situation is particularly disappointing, especially considering the substantial time allotted for the development of the New Glenn rocket. It has been 11 years since its maiden announcement. Given the lengthy development time, any additional delays should have been avoided at all costs. These challenges are likely to arise from significant concerns about New Glenn. The prevailing consensus is that the underlying issues stem from technical difficulties encountered the previous year. In August, the rocket's upper stage was damaged while being transported to a hangar. In an unrelated incident, another upper stage failed during stress testing, resulting in an explosion. These occurrences probably elucidate why New Glenn has remained on the launch pad for an extended period without any notable testing taking place. The company seems to be adopting a prudent approach to prevent any additional incidents that may endanger the vehicle's integrity. Indeed, these instances merely represent the surface of a much broader phenomenon. They encapsulate the larger challenges confronting Blue Origin, particularly its difficulties in scaling up production of New Glenn, a project that is already 4 years behind its original timeline. In addition to overcoming technical challenges, the company is grappling with complexities in its research and development initiatives. This spurred the newly appointed CEO, Dave Lim, to convene a team of executives entrusted with the mission of rejuvenating the company and navigating it away from a prolonged period of stagnation. The inaugural flights of New Glenn have now been slotted for January 10th, a date that intriguingly aligns with SpaceX Starship Flight 7, possibly by design. It appears that BIOS has resolved to confront SpaceX, their most formidable rival, head-on this time. January 10th is poised to be an exciting day for the space community, is it not? Nevertheless, we cannot completely dismiss the chance of a further postponement. It is my earnest desire that such an occurrence does not transpire. The propensity of Blue Origin for delays renders this outcome a distinct possibility. Let us remain optimistic that they adhere to the timeline on this occasion. At the very least, it will establish the groundwork for one of the most intense rivalries in the annals of space history between these two industry juggernauts. What distinguished the inaugural flight of New Glenn? Blue Origin officially unveiled the New Glenn project in 2016, strategically positioning it as a rocket engineer to surpass the capabilities of SpaceX's Falcon 9. Boasting the capacity to transport up to 5 metric tons into orbit, New Glenn aspires to establish a benchmark for heavy lift launch vehicles. In the realm of inaugural flights, aerospace enterprises frequently adopt a prudent strategy, choosing to deploy surrogate payloads, such as metallic blocks. In 2018, SpaceX notably launched a cherry red sports car as part of the inaugural flight of its Falcon Heavy rocket. Blue Origin, nonetheless, has consistently underscored its dedication to a deliberate and thorough development process, placing a premium on reliability. This methodology is encapsulated by the company's mascot, a tortoise, which embodies the timeless adage from the classic fable, "Perseverance and steadiness triumph in the end." Blue Origin's founder, Jeff Bezos, articulated in 2016 the philosophy that slow is smooth and smooth is fast. These comments appear to position Blue Origin as the polar opposite of SpaceX, which has cultivated its reputation through a philosophy of rapid development that inherently values trial and error. Notwithstanding its methodical strategy, SpaceX has consistently asserted its triumph in the quest for orbital supremacy. With the successful launch of its inaugural orbital rocket, Falcon 1, in September 2008, the company has subsequently accomplished hundreds of missions. The Falcon 9, serving as the cornerstone of the SpaceX fleet, boasts an outstanding operational track record, having experienced merely two in-flight failures and a single launch pad explosion throughout its history, none of which occurred during crewed space missions. Although SpaceX frequently relinquishes rockets during testing to expedite innovation, its performance on operational missions is exemplary. In contrast, Blue Origin has predominantly garnered recognition for its initiatives in space tourism. The suborbital New Shepard rocket embarked on excursions to the brink of space, transporting paying patrons and celebrities alike for fleeting journeys. Although New Shepard lacks the capability to launch satellites into orbit, it has successfully completed over 20 flights, with only one failure in its uncrewed missions. As New Glenn gears up for its inaugural flight, it represents a pivotal advancement for Blue Origin in its quest to enter the competitive orbital launch sector. In the interim, the competitive dynamic involving SpaceX's founder and CEO, Elon Musk, continues to captivate public interest. Despite their extensively chronicled rivalry, Elon extended words of encouragement for New Glenn's inaugural launch by posting "Godspeed" on the X platform on December 27th. Nevertheless, Bezos continues to harbor optimism that Blue Origin will emerge as a formidable competitor, poised to contest SpaceX's supremacy. The shift from achieving might completion to attaining well completion presents a significantly greater challenge. Provided that everything proceeds as planned with the scheduled test flights of New Glenn, free from any delays, it is noteworthy that during this interval, SpaceX has been consistently launching and successfully landing its Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy rockets for several years. The significance of flight data collected from the multitude of SpaceX launches and landings is paramount, as it enhances the systems and operational procedures of the Falcon 9 series, while also optimizing the design of the Starship. In the forthcoming 3 years, SpaceX anticipates further optimizing its operations, thereby enhancing its already remarkable launch frequency. It is plausible that as much as 50% of the year's launches could consist of Starship missions dedicated to payload deployments. As SpaceX intends to halt the advancement of the Falcon 9 series following the current iteration, its reliability is poised for continued enhancement. In the interim, New Glenn will make its inaugural appearance as a wholly new rocket, lacking any prior launch history, in competition with the Falcon 9, which boasts a proven and extensive record of successful launches. In order to entice customers away from SpaceX, Blue Origin must provide launch services at a substantially reduced cost compared to that of the Falcon 9. At present, the Falcon Heavy's listed price for its expendable configuration, utilizing 3 new cores, significantly undercuts the cost per kilogram to orbit of any other available launch vehicle. Furthermore, Starship is strategically positioned to swiftly obtain multi-million dollar contracts, owing to its capacity to transport 150 tons to orbit, facilitate in-orbit refueling, and subsequently launch an additional 150 tons. It will indeed be a formidable challenge for New Glenn or any existing launch system to rival that. The anticipated marginal cost per Starship flight, encompassing expenses related to fuel oxidizer, range, and flight control, is expected to be sufficiently low, enabling SpaceX to surpass New Glenn's production costs while still maintaining profitability. That being noted, one should not regard New Glenn as a mere underperformer within the aerospace sector. When considering its payload capacity, the New Glenn rocket undoubtedly asserts itself as a formidable contender. New Glenn boasts considerable strength, classified as a heavy lift vehicle. Its capabilities reside in a range that bridges the performance of SpaceX's Falcon 9 and that of the Falcon Heavy launch vehicle. For instance, SpaceX's Falcon 9, regarded as the workhorse of the fleet, possesses the capability to transport up to 23 metric tons into space. New Glenn has the capacity to achieve double that, and its pricing may align closely with that of a Falcon 9, which is reportedly in the range of $60 to $70 million. Caleb Henry, the director of research at Goldie Space, an organization specializing in data and analytical insights regarding the space industry, posited that to effectively compete with Falcon 9, one must either match or exceed its pricing strategy. The pivotal inquiry, however, pertains to BO's capacity to maintain a competitive pricing structure, Henry remarked, Nonetheless, a distinguishing characteristic of New Glenn is its expansive payload fairing nose cone. The component serves to safeguard the cargo bay and boasts an impressive width of 7 meters, nearly 2 meters larger than that of the Falcon 9 or Falcon Heavy. Henry suggested that Blorgen probably chose to equip New Glenn with a substantial ferry to align with Bezos's vision for the future. The technology magnate has consistently articulated an aspiration to relocate manufacturing and other environmentally detrimental heavy industries beyond Earth, envisioning our home planet as a terrestrial sanctuary for humanity to explore and appreciate. To achieve this, it is imperative to utilize rockets capable of transporting substantial payloads. While New Glenn surpasses Falcon 9 in terms of thrust, SpaceX is currently engaged in the development of a pioneering flagship for its rocket portfolio. Similar to Bezos, Elon Musk of SpaceX envisions a future in which humanity resides and engages in activities on other planets, particularly Mars. To facilitate this vision, SpaceX is in the process of developing Starship, the largest and most potent launch vehicle ever engineered. The nearly 121-meter rocket surpasses New Glenn in every conceivable dimension. Elon aspires for the Starship to transport up to 300 tons into orbit. SpaceX's Starship represents a groundbreaking advancement in rocket technology with the potential to render all existing models obsolete. Its primary objective is to significantly lower the cost per kilogram for transporting cargo and passengers to space. The outcome of this remains uncertain. However, I believe that should SpaceX persist in reducing the expense associated with space access, they will perpetually maintain their position as the preeminent competitor, remarked Henry. Although it may prove difficult to eclipse SpaceX, New Glenn has, in certain respects, already established its presence within the launch industry. Blorgen has long positioned itself as a contender against both SpaceX and ULA, the latter being a collaborative endeavor between Boeing and Lockheed Martin, which procures engines from Blue Origin to secure profitable military launch contracts. In June, the Space Force designated Blue Origin, ULA, and SpaceX as contenders for approximately $6 billion in Pentagon contracts aimed at national security endeavors scheduled for launch over the forthcoming 4 years. Blorgen has established partnerships with numerous commercial enterprises for the deployment of satellites. The agreements encompass strategies for the deployment of Amazon's Kuiper Internet satellites, alongside a recently established partnership with AST Space Mobile, aimed at facilitating the launch of the Midland, Texas-based company's space-based cellular broadband network. New Glenn may play a pivotal role in the construction of Blue Origin's envisioned space station within its orbital reef. Blue Origin, alongside its commercial collaborators such as Sierra Space and Boeing, envisions the station evolving into a new haven for astronauts as the International Space Station gradually retires from active service. On its upcoming mission, Blue Origin had intended to send two payloads to Mars for NASA during New Glenn's maiden flight. However, setbacks in the rocket's development have forced the space agency to change its plans, delaying the launch until at least the spring. For its maiden flight, Blue Origin has opted to conduct a demonstration aimed at evaluating technologies critical to the development of its intended Blue Ring spacecraft, which is designed to serve as a space-based rideshare vehicle that facilitates the transport of satellites further into the cosmos when needed. The demonstrator on this New Glenn flight will remain aboard the rocket for the entirety of Blue Origin's designated 6-hour mission, serving to validate orbital communications capabilities with ground systems, while also evaluating in-space telemetry tracking, command hardware, and ground-based radiometric tracking. The Blue Ring Pathfinder demonstrator is an integral component of an agreement between Blue Origin and the U.S. Department of Defense's Innovation Unit. In a defining and groundbreaking maneuver, Blue Origin has chosen to land an entire New Glenn rocket stage aboard an unmanned spacecraft for its maiden flight, thereby signaling to the world its ambition to become only the second private entity, after SpaceX, to successfully launch a reusable rocket. Echoing the strategy used by SpaceX, Blue Origin is working to recover and reuse its first stage boosters to lower launch costs. The company asserted in a recent press release that reuse is critical to significantly lowering the cost per launch, echoing a common sentiment that SpaceX has often championed since its successful landing of its first booster in 2015. Bezos has recognized the importance of reusing rocket components since founding his company in 2000, 2 years before Elon Musk founded SpaceX, and later developed the New Shepard suborbital tourism rocket with reuse in mind. It's not just a copycat, as Harry put it. Blue Origin has championed reuse long before it became a trend in the aerospace industry. Today, the concept has gained a lot of traction and has become a mainstream idea, thanks in large part to SpaceX. The difference lies in the fact that Blue Origin has taken a much longer time to achieve orbital flight. If successful, a safe landing of a return New Glenn booster would be a monumental achievement. After expending most of its fuel to lift the rocket's upper stage into space, the first stage booster must perform a precise separation. That's all for today's episode. See you next time.